click on the subscribe button, especially the bell on the right side. Otherwise, you will miss the latest videos.
We're relaxing in this garden and we're discussing a few things about Trikal Gyan. Trikal Gyan means past, present, future. Okay, the knowledge of past, present and future. Now, let me give a background. There have been few classical works and or rather ancient works where the authors have mentioned that an astrologer should have a sadhana of at least one mantra, okay, for his predictions and for his own protection, okay. In India, the biggest thing is, most astrologers tend to go to such an extent to make their vak siddhi perfect, the ability to vak siddhi means for the predictions to come correct. Okay, they go to such high sadhana, some of them even land up going into Shudra mantras or Shudra Vidya or Tantra just for that, the negative side of Tantra. And some of them land up even visiting Samshan, that is a burial ground, sir.
Yes.
Samshan, burial ground, cemetery. So Ramchandra ji is with us and we were discussing about this, and he was telling us ki kidhar aapko ye mantra mila tha sir, kaun se kitab mein, from which book sir?
Ek mujhe raddi ki book thi.
Achha, raddi wale ke,
raddi wale ke paas.
Okay, raddi wala means kabadi, it is like where you sell old items at you know, you just throw the thing at, sell it at the paper price, right? तो वो कहाँ पे था? बॉम्बे में? यू गॉट इट इन बॉम्बे और वेर यू?
बॉम्बे में.
बॉम्बे में कहाँ पे सर?
वो अपना माहिम स्टेशन के बाजू में, जो बंगार वाले, सॉरी.
ओके,
मैं वो स्टेशन का नाम भूल गया है.
अच्छा, उसके आसपास
आसपास में बंगार वाले हैं, उनके पास वो बुक्स, बेसिकली ओल्ड बुक्स बेचते
हैं. ओल्ड बुक्स बेचते
लेते हैं और बेचते हैं.
हाँ.
तो उनके पास वो मेरे को
कितना साल पहले मिली थी आपको?
ये हो गया 6-7 साल पहले.
6-7 साल. Because if you put a video out immediately.
Matunga station ke baju.
Matunga station. Acha, acha. That Matunga Mahim, that link, I know. Matunga Road and Mahima nearby. So, I'll explain it in English because if you remove a video out in Hindi, many people write to us asking us to translate in English and we don't have so many translators. So, he got this from this shop. Now, the beauty about this is, in that book, an old book, okay, there was a very elaborate mantra, okay, for Kal Gyan. Okay, the mantra is called Kal Gyan mantra. That is, if you practice this mantra, you will get siddhi of past, present and future. And guess what, he came and he gave it to me. It is so big, front and back, and couple of times, you know, he's written two and all that. So this is like actually 4 times what you see, okay, twice you have to repeat, then it becomes one mantra. The whole mantra is so big, it's so big, okay, it's, now you know what, at the end of the mantra, okay, I saw, this is Varahamihira. Virchityan Sampurna.
मैं उसका पढ़ के सुनाता
हूँ. लास्ट खाली ये पढ़ा ये.
इति श्री काल ज्ञान मंत्र कुटरम श्री अखिल भूमंडलो परिविभूत गणक चक्र चुड़ामणि वराह मिहिर वीरचिंतया. यानी वराह मिहिर जी ने ये लिखा हुआ है.
ओके, दिस मंत्र इज बाय वराह मिहिर. सो ही गॉट दिस आउट ऑफ एन ओल्ड बुक. ओके, And probably Varahamihir would have been practicing it. And we all know Varahamihir's predictive ability. You know, he was one of the greatest predictors ever in the last 2000 years. So, the point is, what I was trying to say, like, he has given it to me. And, you know, when he started practicing this, okay, in 1 month, he could probably see, okay, this child is going to have an accident or is going to fall. And within few minutes, it would happen, something like that. So he had many experiences like that. But when he approached his guru said, no, stop it. Because, you know, when you get a mantra, we do not know what effects it would have on your own personal life. Whether in the long run it will be correct or bad for you. And are you following the correct procedure, the correct sadhana? Okay. So, Varahamihir probably wrote it. And you should always listen to your guru's saying. Because ideally when you are doing a mantra, it should be, you know, kind of given by the guru. Okay. And then the guru will also control seeing what's happening in your life and all that. So when Ramchandraji was doing this, he felt the power of the mantra, and he also told me that his indriyas were kind of different sensations, all that were happening in his body. The point is, the purest mantra, okay, is in our this thing, is the Gayatri Mantra, it is called. Gayatri Mantra is considered one of the most purest mantras. And and the thing is, you know, I was speaking to one of my team members yesterday, and he was telling that his brother's father-in-law.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry.
So he was telling his brother's father-in-law is 93 years old and stays somewhere in UP. So he's a very moody guy. He doesn't see charts and all that. He's an astrologer. He says it is, I mean, I'll just tell you one of his predictions. He was hospitalized for some heart problem or something, and you won't believe, he was hospitalized for some heart problem. This father-in-law, 93-year-old guy. And he kind of, the doctor said, he asked the doctor, you don't have a child? The doctor said yes. The doctor was operating on him or something like that. And he said, okay, you want a child? I'll get you a child. So he said, how? So he said, just get me some bhang. Bhang, I think it's called cannabis or something like that. So, which we use in Holi for, you know, Holi festival we use it. So, he got him some bhang next day. So, and he did something, he said, now you go, you'll get a child. And next year the doctor got a child. I mean, for a couple of years he was not getting a child. Now when he was asked what's the secret of becoming an astrologer, he said, you have to, I mean, how he became an astrologer in such great siddhis or something, okay, such great powers, is he, what do you call, he for 1 year, daily for 3 hours, he would stand in Ganga, submerge himself and stand on one leg, just one leg, for 3 hours and recite Gayatri Mantra. He said that is compulsory for his level of whatever level he's reached. Okay. And he said every day you have to take Ganga Jal. You have to take Ganga Jal. So that's the level of purity or, you know, or sadhana, you know. And it's fascinating. Of course, you know, many astrologers have achieved many things in astrology via their sadhana. But I personally believe, you know, it's like if you compare us and a Western astrologer. You know, a Western astrologer does not have any mantra, tantra to make his predictions great. Most Indian astrologers land up doing that and make their predictions great. Okay? And apart from the reason of protecting themselves, you know. But most of them do it only for the greed of making their predictions or their predictive ability great. Okay? And I feel, you know, it's like you're going to a war, okay, with a nuclear weapon. Okay, with a nuclear weapon, and whereas the other person does not even have a revolver. So the Western astrologer is far better than us because he's purely taking it to the science level, you know. But anyway, just sharing stories and this thing. And please don't ask me for this mantra. I'm not going to give it to anyone. Anyone means absolutely anyone. Don't even, especially my personal friends, don't even WhatsApp me or FB me and ask me, because it will put me in an uncomfortable position. So, because I don't believe you need this. You don't need this right now. If you take it as a science, do your normal japa of Lord Ganpati or Sri Ram or Lord Shiva. That's more than enough. As long as your intention is to help the client with your prediction, not to just fascinate him with your predictive ability. So that's about it. I was just speaking to Ramchandra ji and this topic came up. Okay. Thank you.